Welcome to Rock of Faith. You can watch our services live, view our church calendar with up-to-date announcements, send a prayer request to our prayer team, and watch Dan Bennett's Bible studies. All this and more at roffont.com. The link is in the video description below.
Praise the Lord. Good morning, everyone. It's good to see each one here. We say God bless you. I've always been told this is weather for the ducks, so I guess we're ducks. Amen. Anyway, I'm glad to be here this morning. I really am enjoying the rain. Praise the Lord. It's soon enough going to be 100 degrees, so I'm going to thank you, Lord, for the rain. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's lift our hands one more time to the Lord this morning. Lord, we thank you today. Lord, as we lift our hands, Lord, we surrender to your spirit, oh God. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your great love for us, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you for this opportunity to be in your house yet again. Thank you for your kindness, Lord. We bless your wonderful, glorious name. Thank you. That name that's above every other name, Lord. We appreciate, Lord, the right to use that name, Lord. Glory to the Lamb of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. Lord, we give you all the glory and all the praise and all the honor today, Lord. We praise you and we give you glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your goodness. Amen. One more time, would you turn to your neighbor and tell him, I love you and you can't do nothing about it. Tell him, I love you and you can't do nothing about it. Amen. You can be seated on today, if you would. Let's give our praise team a hand. Let's tell them thank you today. We're glad that you helped us today. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're glad that each one is here today. We're going to go ahead and receive our morning tithe and offering. This goes to the expense of our church. We'd like you to give us unto the Lord, and we know the Lord will bless you. Thank you for your goodness to help us. I do have the tithing for last year, and once again, we will be passing it out. If there are any discrepancies, we'll be glad to fix it. We are human beings, after all, and if we've missed it in any way, we'll be glad to fix it. Thank you so much for supporting us in the year 2016, and we look forward to 2017. Now, I've shared this many times before, but I really do live by faith. Hello. I really do live by, amen. My dependency is upon God, and it really is. So it doesn't matter to me on circumstances. I'm depending on God. And I always think about it years ago when we would have revival and just a few people would come. And I remember hearing a preacher say, he said, it's kind of like when you go to dinner with somebody and there's only two people there. Well, if you have 12 people there, they cut the pie in 12 pieces. But if there's just two people, they cut it in half and you get half and they get half. Hello. So I want to tell you, you're going to get a bigger piece of pie this morning. Amen. You're going to get a big piece of pie today. Amen. So, but it's all right. Amen. God is a good God. Amen. I think about a lot of things in the Bible. I love the story of Moses crossing the Red Sea. And some scientists, historians said that there were only 6 inches of water in the Red Sea as they crossed the Red Sea. And a man stood up and said, hallelujah, God drowned Pharaoh's army in 6 inches of water. Amen. They actually found artifacts from his army in the Red Sea. So we know he's down there somewhere. Praise the Lord. I'm having fun. It's a good day today. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. It's a good day today. Amen. I feel his presence today. Something good's about to happen. Amen. We're going to go ahead and receive our offering today. Whatever you can do to help us is always appreciated, and we thank you in advance. Amen. Father, we thank you this morning. We ask your blessing upon the offering. We ask you to bless the gift and the giver. Some way, somehow, we ask you to return it to your people. And Lord, you know in my heart that I look to you for our prosperity and our blessing. And I look to you to take care of us in this year. May you bless your people, Lord, and we give you glory, praise, and honor. Bless our efforts as a church as we minister to the people. We give you glory, praise, and honor. We ask these things today in your name, the name of Jesus, and everyone said, amen. If you have an offering, please bring it to the storehouse of the Lord. Amen. Well, we are privileged today to have Pastor Dan in service with us. We're looking forward to enjoying the teaching of the Word of God today. If you open your heart to the Lord this morning, I believe God has something special for us all. And we're advancing in January. We've been praying and fasting in this month to lay a foundation for the new year. And as I look back on 2016, I realized that our prayer made the difference in our church services and our year that God provided for us. And you will never be able to figure out how he'll do it. But if you will pray and believe and trust in God, he will get the job done. He will help you. He will see you through. He will make provision for you. But you can't figure it out. So don't try to get it through your head because you'll just get a headache. Amen. If you trust, you'll find out that God knows how to do things better than you do. And he makes provision for us. Pastor Dan is here to teach us the Word of God this morning. So let's open our hearts and let's welcome Pastor Dan as he comes. And let's receive the Word of God. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. How y'all doing? Really doing good. Got a Bible? Got to tell them where to. I said, to what Bible, what page or what? I said, just anywhere. It's all good. He looked at me like I'm screwed. It's good to be here. I'm tired today. I did a pastor's seminar in L.A. yesterday. I don't know where that came from, but that made me really fat. If you have your Bible, open it up to Luke chapter 9. I touched on what I'm going to share with you today a little bit at our last Bible study. Last Friday we did that. I want to talk about the power in the name of Jesus. Not in your name. In the name of Jesus. I found out a long time ago my name didn't have any power. A friend of mine said, would you pray for this guy? This is years ago. I didn't even know how to pray. I said, well, yeah, I guess so. And I saw him looking at me. He probably thought, poor guy, I don't know nothing. The power that you need is in the name of Jesus. That's where it is. The guys on TV that tell you they got that power, they don't. They raise the dead. I never seen one do it yet. God told me, he said, sure nice to meet you, Pastor Dan. I heard about you. I said, oh, well, thank you. He said, yeah, I raised the dead. I said, I've been looking for you. He said, what? I said, I've been looking for somebody like you. I said, you know what there is right across the street over here? He said, what? I said, a graveyard. And he started backing up. He started looking. I said, as soon as we get through with the service, you can go over there and raise up some of those people. I said, we'll find the ones that's died recently. I turned around and looked, and a little while he was gone. You can pray for people in my name all you want to. Won't nothing happen. The power that we need. Now listen, we do have the power of the Holy Spirit residing on the inside of us. But John told us, he said, after the Holy Ghost come upon you, he'll lead and guide you into all the truth and show you things to come. That's basically what the Holy Spirit does. But he does more than that. He fills us with the Holy Spirit. And yes, we do have power in ourselves, but not in our name. I've seen a guy pray for people using his own name. He said, now I'm Pastor so-and-so, and I pray for you, and you'll be healed and all that stuff. And I thought, boy, this is going to be fun. Nothing happened. Everybody was looking around like, well, he's supposed to pray for people and they get healed. What happened? He didn't use the name. There is a name that's above every name that can be named, and that's Jesus. Guy said, would you come to our church and heal people? I said, no, but I'll come to your church and pray on healing, and I'll pray for them. I will come and teach on healing, and then I will pray for them in faith in the name of Jesus. But no, I won't heal them. Next time you think you can heal something, go heal it. Go to the graveyard and see if you can raise up a dead person. You can't. Jesus never gave us the power to do that except through his name, because he's the one that's doing it, not us. If I write your name on my check, guess what the bank will tell me? Nah, never heard of this one. This guy. The name that opens every door and brings power is the name of Jesus. When we go tell people we do all of these things and we don't do them, we are liars. And the church has got a lot of lying preachers. They're on TV getting your money while you working at the car wash. They're riding in a jet. Now, Luke 9:1. This is Jesus. Then he called his disciples, his 12 disciples together, and they gave, listen, and he gave them power and authority over devils and to cure diseases, and he sent them to preach the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. Now, wait a minute. It says he gave them power and authority over all devils. Just wait. Verse 3, he said unto them, take nothing for your journey, neither staves or a crutch or something like that, or scrip, that's money, neither bread, neither money again, neither have two coats apiece. Wow. And whatsoever house you enter into, there abide and stay. And then depart. And I'm reading from a real old King James. Verse 5. And whosoever will not receive you then, when you go out of that city, shake off the very dust from your feet for a testimony against them. And they departed and went through the towns preaching the gospel and healing everywhere. Now, from what I read you, you can assume that he gave them the power to do it within themselves, but it doesn't say that. He said he gave them power and authority. I worked for a company one time. I had authority there, and I had power over certain things that happened. But it didn't happen because of my name. It happened because the person I was working for used me to do that. God will use you, but the day you start saying you heal people and you raise people from the dead and you do all this stuff, you are a liar. But I prayed for people, and God instantly healed them. Instantly. Oh, well, you had a part in it. The only part I had, I said, in the name of Jesus. Now, I'm going to show you in a minute. The power that you need is in the name of Jesus. It's not in your head. It's not because you have the Holy Spirit. You can do everything that God could do. You can't do everything that God could do. If you can, get up and do it right now. There's people in here who need help. If you got it, well, come on, show us. You don't have it. But if we do these things, pray for the sick and all of these things that we do, and we do it in the name of Jesus, that's the power. That's where the power comes from. Can you sign any name on your check? Only one name has the power of attorney to write that check. Who is it? You. Now, you can give me your power of attorney, and then I can write a check on your account just like you do. If I don't tell you, you don't know it until you go to look at the bank. See, Jesus give us the power of attorney. See, when you got married, ladies, you had a different name. And then when you got married, guess what that man did? He gave you his name. And he put you on his checkbook. But it was his checkbook But now he says you can use power of attorney. And so my wife used to write Lynn Bennett on him checks a lot. She didn't ask me or nothing. I thought maybe I made a mistake. No, Jesus gives us the power of attorney to do these things. It's not us doing them. It's us doing something, but through his power, his name, his ability, not ours. I don't have the ability. Guy said to me, well, you know, Philip, he was translated over and met the eunuch in the on the wagon with the horse and all that stuff. He said, can you translate yourself somewhere? And I was in the wrong church, and I said, yes, sir, I can. I'm getting ready to do it right now. This is a true story. He said, what are you going to do? I said, I'm going to translate myself from here to my car, and I'm going home. People were nuts over there. We go all over the world. We see lots of things. We see God heal people of leprosy, a bunch of things. But I never healed anybody of leprosy. And what I want to bring you in just a few minutes, we're headed that way, is the power is in the name of Jesus. That name has power over principalities and powers, wicked spirits in the heavenlies, sickness, disease, poverty. It has power over everything. But not everybody has the authority to go do it. He didn't tell the whole world they could do that. He said the 12 disciples could do it. He said, I'm going to give you power and authority to go out there and do it. Well, we're going to find out in just 3 or 4 scriptures how that power and authority works. First of all, you got to be born again and you got to be a believer. I don't believe there was a Jesus. I believe it and I know it too. But some people, they don't really believe that Jesus ever existed. But they'll try to use and make formulas out of the Bible. This is not formulas. This is truth. Absolute truth. And it works. How long have you been preaching? Like 30 years almost or something. 29 and a half, pretty close to 30. Do you ever walk on water yet? Did you want to? Can you walk on water? Jesus could. Hey, wait a minute. Peter could. Oh, but guess what Jesus said? He said, Lord, if that's you, let me come out there. And Jesus said, come. And he stepped out, and you know what he was walking on? God's word. What do you think was holding him up? When he couldn't do it, and then when he said, let me come out there, he said, come, one word. But see, that word come in there is not to you. Who was it to? Peter. But God can do the same thing with you if he wants to. Pastor Jess, I think, knew somebody that said they were going to do that. Was that you? And he told a lot of people, and they went over, and he didn't even get one step, did he? Boom. I know a guy that did it too. He put it in the paper and everything. God had called him, spoke to him on a mountain. I thought he must have been smoking something weird when he was up there on that mountain. He heard God speaking to him. He said, go down to somewhere and walk on the water, and people are going to come from all over the country, and you'll be famous. Expose himself out there, and I'll be famous. Do you think the dummy really thought he's going to walk on water? Well, he got up there on that thing, and he stepped off. Boom. And everybody started laughing. He thought he was something when he wasn't really. You know what we are? Sinners saved by grace. And we sometimes still sin. Don't practice sin anymore. But sometimes you can sin by commission or omission. You can just say, well, do you know her? Oh, yeah, I've known her for many years, never met her in my life. Well, I just lied. But if I'm standing in front of a new BMW, looking at it, and you look, come by and say, is that your car? Yeah. Can I take a picture of you with it? Sure, go ahead. Or what if I don't say anything? What if he says, that's your car, and I just go. I didn't say it was mine, but I acted like it was mine. See, we're lying sometimes. We don't even know we're lying. Are you mad yet? No, good. Hallelujah. All right, listen. Now listen. Luke 10:17. Something's going to take place after a while. I don't know what it is. Luke 10:17. First, it was the 12 disciples that he told that they could go out and do these things. Now, in Luke chapter 10, starting with verse 17, he's going to tell 70 new people that he picked to work with him in the ministry. He's going to tell them to go out and do the same thing. So the 12 did it first, and now they've got 70 new disciples. They're going to do it. Now watch, verse 17, Luke 10. And the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject to you. No, unto us. Through what? What did it? It's not you doing it. That's the reason they guys make fools out of themselves. Got to raise from the dead. I saw a guy do that in a thing one time. I thought, oh my God. And I saw another lady laying on a grave where when she left, we went over and looked at the gravestone. It was her husband. He was a pastor and he died. And she was telling him, come back. Come back. We could hear her. She's laying on, come back. Come back. And I thought, oh my God. She was crying. Then she went to the car and got a little dog and laid the little dog on the grave there, you know, and was holding him. And he was trying to get loose. And she's saying, come up now. Come up now. I thought, this lady is absolutely out of it. She got up and got in her car and left. We don't have the power to do that. Stay away from people that tell you they can do all those dumb things. They can't do them. Can you change water into wine? Can you turn water into wine? Said, if I could, I'd have the biggest wine store in America. I'd just get water and turn it into all kinds of wine. Can't do it. Won't work. See, we try to be little gods, and there is a reference to it in the Old Testament, but it don't mean you're a little god. You're not even a midget god. You can do nothing that Jesus can do. The only thing you can do that Jesus did is through his name. Listen to this. This is important. See, when you read words, you ought to find out what they mean. And surely you can understand this. Verse 17. The 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject unto us. What? I'm able to buy you this box of Kleenex through the money that he provided because I don't have any. When it comes to doing what God did, you absolutely cannot do it unless you use the name. It's the only thing you've got that's got power. What do you have that has great power that can raise the dead, heal the sick, open blinded eyes? You know anybody can do that? Is there any medicine that can do that? No. I wish I could invent a medicine to make you well. I'd give you some for free. But Jesus gave the church his name. Not the world. Not them lying people on TV that's not really real. They don't have any power to do nothing. Oh, no, that's not true. They know how to manipulate you and get your money. Oh, sin today and we'll send you this calendar. I don't want them stupid calendars. Why don't I give him any money? I ain't giving my money for a calendar. He said, help us support our ministry. They don't have one. He talked about how many people he raised from the dead in a foreign country. He lied. He didn't raise them from the dead. You ever had your animal die? Could you raise him up? You ever have a relative die? Could you raise them up? Well, you're a Christian and you got the name of Jesus and you can do anything. Why can't you do anything? Oh, we can just do some things. You have to do it in line with the Word of God. I'll show you in a minute. What gives the name power is the Word that's behind it, and it came from God. I'm not God. I used to be God of my own life. And that was a joke too. How about you? Listen, he said, even the devils are subject unto us through your name. And he, that's Jesus, said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning falling from heaven. Behold, I give you power to tread on what? Serpents and scorpions. That's talking about demon powers and principalities. And over all the power of who? And nothing by any means shall hurt you. You believe that? Well, I believe it, but I've had things that hurt me. Have you? You ever had your teeth pulled? They hurt. I just say like, no, it will not hurt me. You want a shot? No, thanks. And I've got authority over everything. You don't have authority over everything. If you surrender your life to Jesus and you give him your life and you do what he asked you to do, in his name you can go see him do things as you lay hands on him. See, what does it say in James? If there's any sick among you, let them call for the elders of the church. They will anoint you with oil and pray the prayer of faith over you. Listen, and God will raise them up. God said, are you a healer and can you raise the dead? I said, no, but I know how to pray in the name of Jesus. Do you? I know a guy that always said, I like to pray in the old man upstairs. I said, I got an old man that lives upstairs in our house. You don't want him to pray for nobody. Vile, vulgar person. It ain't the old man upstairs. It's God. And Jesus, Isaiah said he was God, Emmanuel. That means God manifested in the flesh. He could do all of those things. But I can't. But I prayed for thousands of people that got healed. We've led a lot of people to receive the Holy Spirit, hundreds, thousands of them all over. Go to Asia with me sometime, and when you have a meeting, brother, you have a meeting. Not 12 people come. They start coming, and it looks like a bunch of birds flying or something. They come in mass bunches of people. Why? Because there's no word there. There's no power of God there except in a few churches scattered around. Now they have more, but still a lot of them still practice what they did before in the church. While they're praising Jesus, they're trying to do things, manipulate and control. Now, verse 19, because I give unto you power, did he say give them power to tread on serpents and scorpions, I'll get out in a minute, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Notwithstanding, in this rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather because what? If you're not saved, you can't do any of this. None of it. We got people that are not even saved that are pastoring churches. I was shocked. I thought they're going to give an altar call here in a minute. Mm-hmm. They said, we're going to have worship. Oh, there was only one problem. It was music. It wasn't worship. Nobody worshiped anything. What are they? They are pretense. They're a substitute for the real deal, and there's no substitute for God and his word. You want God to use you? He'll use you till he uses you up. He will pursue you forever because he's in love with you and he died for you. But you're not going to do one thing in his name unless your name is written in heaven and you're a disciple of Christ and you're serving him with your life. We play games with God. Do you think God plays? God don't play. No kind of games. You've got to be straight up honest with God and do what God said to do. And yes, you can pray for the sick. If you do it in faith and honor them with all, and he says, and God will raise them up. I wonder if all those guys never read that scripture. It exposes them as liars. It don't say, and men will raise you up, does it? Only Jesus can do that. See, the minute you tell me some of this stuff, see, I've been reading the Bible a long time, like 57, 58 years or something. A long time. And tell me you're raising people from the dead. I know you're not. But I didn't say God couldn't use you to pray for somebody, because I prayed for a lady that fell in our floor in the church. She just fell down and boom, hit the floor, and she was dead. That's what the paramedic said. And my pastor was there. He's a real old man then. He said, "Hey, boy, what you going to do?" I said, "What?" He said, "What you going to do?" I said, "I ain't going to do nothing. She's dead. We're going to call an ambulance." He said, "Go over there and pray for her. Do you know she's dead?" I said, "No, I'm not a doctor. I don't know if she's dead or not, but she's blue and she ain't breathing." He said, "Pray for her." I said, "Okay." I said, "I didn't even want to touch her." I said, "In the name of Jesus, get up." What happened? Nothing. I said, "You spirit of death, come out of her. I don't know if there's one in her or not. I know what to do." I said, "Father, I can't do nothing. Lord Jesus, do something." And she went, started breathing. The paramedic stayed till the fire department got there, and he told him she was not breathing for 3 or 4 minutes or whatever it was. And she looked bad. And when she got up, they wanted to take her off in a gurney. She said, "I'm not going." She said, "I feel good." Color started coming back in her face. God can do anything. There's no limit except me and you and our abilities to serve God and do what He wants us to do. That's all we got to do. That's a lot. That's a lot. Go over to First Church of Nothing and leave a good Pentecostal church. Sometimes people do, and because they, well, you know, over there they got a lot more people, and you people are weird. You dance around and shout, clap your hands and all that. They run over to that. That's the house of death. No power, no anointing, no ability. Ain't very many people here today. Usually a lot more than this, but I know what's wrong. It's the weather. People are down. But listen, you can't do anything except in His name. And if you pray and say, "Now be healed. Thank you, Lord, for healing." No. In the name of Jesus. Oh, we don't like to do that. It embarrasses people. Well, let them leave. God told me, He said, "You know, you preach too loud." I said, "Well, this big, go back there and sit on the back row." God said, "I want to tell you something." I said, "What's it about?" He said, "It's about translation by the Spirit of God." I said, "I don't hear it." He said, "Well, I can translate from here to somewhere." I said, "Well, translate through the back door." That's what I told him. Translate through the back door. Be seeing you. Bye. He couldn't translate anywhere. Don't believe none of that stuff. Don't watch them people on TV. You know what happens when you do? They're indoctrinating you. I knew a man, a real powerful man of God, who was a wonderful, wonderful preacher for many years, and I worked for him. I was a superintendent for their organization right here in California, in Southern California. His name was Kenneth Hagin. He was a good man, a real good man, but a lot of people that came out from his ministry, you know, they turned into false doctors, started teaching false doctors. They said, "This is just what Kenneth Hagin taught." No, it wasn't. He was a strange man. One time I saw him. I worked for his son-in-law, who was Buddy Harrison, who owned Harrison House Printing. And I said, "How are you, Brother Hagin?" And he went, "Okay." He's like, walks around like that all day. Prays, walked all over there. All over the campus and everything, praying for him. "Hey, how you doing? Put your hand out." He said, "I'm doing pretty good. Just what I just did to you." "So I'm doing pretty good. How are you?" What does he mean? No. Was he strange? Yes. He had a walk with God that most people don't have. I've been around some men that really know God, and really walk in the power and demonstration of the Holy Spirit. And they're all different. They don't ignore you. They just don't get into no deep conversation with you. What are you saying? I'm saying that there are people who know Jesus better than we do, and they do things that we can't do, but they're still doing it through the name of Jesus. That's the power source. And when you start claiming that you're doing all these things that's happening in your ministry, you're in trouble. Let's look at Acts real quick. Acts chapter 3. Here is an example of the use of Jesus' name in action. Acts 3. Verse 1, now Peter and John went up into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. And a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, a man that was crippled from birth from his mother's womb, who they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, and asked alms of them that entered into the temple. He was born this way. He didn't get in a car wreck. Or a camel wreck, or a mule wreck, or whatever. He was born this way. Verse 3, who seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. They wanted some money. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, look on us. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something from them. He is going to, but he thought it was going to be money. Money's not the answer to everything. Now watch. And Peter, fastening his eyes, verse 4, upon him with John, said, look on us. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something. Watch now. Then Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I what? What did he have? He had something. It didn't mean he possessed it. He meant it was a part of his life. He had something. What did he have? Watch. Then Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have I give thee in the name of Dan Bennett. That's me. In the name of George Washington. He didn't live then. But such as I have, I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, rise up and walk. I've said it a million times to people. It don't mean I do it. It means the name has the power to get what you're asking for, as long as that's written in the Bible. It's got to be in there. Did he tell them to say that? Yeah, then that you can do it. You too can do it. But the part you do is you pray in faith in the name of Jesus. I'm not a faith healer. I'm a faith prayer. I pray for people in faith. I honestly do. With all of my heart, I believe God will raise them up. And he healed two or three of them. Lepers, one in Southeast Asia and one in Mexico City. They had leprosy. Nose about half ate off their fingers. And they got healed. Said, well, what did they do to you? Well, I wasn't there when it happened. They went home, and then they come back the next day and showed us. I was shocked. And he kept saying, oh, thank you, thank you. And he had money in his hand to give me. I said, I don't want that money. What would happen to me if I take the money for healing that guy? I wouldn't be in the ministry anymore. I'd be washing dishes over here at the restroom somewhere. You don't have the right to be Jesus. And you're not Jesus. But Jesus lives inside of you. I told you what that guy said about money, didn't I? The guy said to me one time, do you have money? I said, no. He said, well, how'd you get over here? I said, by faith. He said, how are you going to get home? I said, by faith. And he said, but where will you get the money? And I said, don't worry, honey. There's a little Jew that lives inside of me. God will give it to me. How does he do that? In ways you could never dream. God is good. Say, God is good. What healed this man? He said, Peter said, such as I have. He said, I don't have any money. I don't have gold. I don't have a hospital. I don't have nothing. But such as I have, I give unto thee in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. What did he say, do? No. He said, in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. Not just rise up. Like that lady laying on that, I never forget it. Come, she said. Her husband's dead in there. And she went and got the dog and stuck his nose over there. And he's yelping and said, come up. I thought, ooh. I told him, why? Come here, look at this weirdo. I know she was having sorrow, but what she was doing is trying to practice witchcraft. That's what she was trying to do, but guess what? It wasn't working, and the dog didn't like it. That dog wanted to get away from there. Lay that dog over there and make him lay on that grave. What they forget is the powers in the name. Go on down to verse 12. And when Peter saw it, saw the man was healed. We'll read 11. And as the lame man which was healed helped Peter and John, all the people ran together unto them in the porch that is called Solomon's, greatly wondering. And when Peter saw it, he answered unto the people, ye men of Israel, why marvel you at this? Or why look you so earnestly on us as though, now listen, as though by our own power. He said, we didn't do this on our own power. What are you running and screaming and hollering and think we did something? He said he didn't do it. Is that what he said? Look at verse 16. And his name, whose name? Through faith in what? Ah, you prayed, but they didn't raise up. They didn't get healed because you didn't pray in faith in his name. Hail Mary, full of grace, blessed art thou, and blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus, get up. Ain't getting up. You against Catholics? I'm not against anybody. I'm for Jesus. If you love Jesus and serve Jesus, I love you. But I ain't going to join up with nobody else. I got hooked up to the giver of life. That don't mean I'm going to live forever either. I heard a guy say that I'm going to live forever. We're going to live forever. He said he was going to live forever. I said you are. But now you got to figure out what spot you're going to be in. You know, some go that way and some go that way. But you'll be living forever. Now listen, verse 16 in Acts 3. And his name through faith in his name hath made. You see the word made? What did God do? God can, I can't do it. I wish I could make myself whole. I wish I could bless myself with $1 million. Come money to me, 1 million right away. Ain't coming. It's a joke. The power is in the name, not in you. You have Holy Ghost power in you. That's how you got baptized in the Holy Spirit. That's how he leads and guides you into all the truth and shows you things to come. But it takes the name of Jesus, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Healer, the Redeemer, the Sanctifier, the Baptizer. He justifies us. He gives us mercy and he gives us grace. He helps us when he ought to dump us. He just keeps on loving you. When you mess up, you pray and he forgives you. And then you say, well, I don't know. I might not go. The lady told me I'm going to go join the Catholic Church. I said, go ahead. She said, you don't care? I said, no, I don't care. I don't have nothing to do with your life. You want to go on over there. What are you looking for? She said, well, they have rituals that they do with blood and stuff. I said, no, I ain't going there. I'll tell you that. That's demonic. Oh, they don't do that anymore, huh? Go to Guatemala. Go to Guatemala. I was preaching in the Catholic Church in Guatemala. And guess what went on after church? The witches and the soothsayers and those that worship the devil come down in the basement and they rented out to them. They had their service in the basement. And they was pouring animal blood from a glass into a jar. Do all Catholics do that? I don't know. I'm not one. People down in there were Catholics. But they were just up there praying to Mary and then to go down there and pray to the devil. They're confused. They're really confused. There's only one God. I'm going to quit in about 5 minutes. Acts 16. Did you notice all of these things we're talking about happen through the name of Jesus? Acts 16. No, I don't want to go there. I did, but I'm going to change it. Let's go back to Acts 3. I missed one. I don't want to miss one. Acts 3. I'm trying to find this name. Here it is. Oh, I've read it, but I want to go back and say something else about it. Acts 3:16, and his name, Jesus' name, through, what's the next word? In what? Faith in what? Do you have faith in the name of Jesus? Do you believe Jesus was a real person? Do you believe that he was born of a woman? And you know what? When the angel told Mary, she said, how in the world is this going to be? I thought she was next to God. She didn't know how it was going to be. And he said, the Holy Ghost is going to move upon you, and you're going to conceive a baby. Supernatural. But he was a man. He was a man. He was given birth to by a woman. But was he God? Yeah. How do you know? Well, look what he did in the Bible. See, stay away from people if you don't know who they are and they tell you, oh, we love God. I don't care about that. Do you love Jesus? Oh, we don't believe in Jesus. But we believe in God. They're both one. They're the same. They said, in the beginning, he was with God. Well, where'd they come from? We don't know. Been up there for eternity, I guess. Spoke the world into existence. What can Jesus do? Everything that you need him to do. But you've got to trust in him alone and his name. See, you pray for somebody earnestly and they get healed. Don't take credit for that. Don't take, oh, look what I did. I get them on TV. Send your money to me right away and I'll do that for you folks. I'll send you a card that I prayed over and my tears dropped on it. I saw a guy on TV. He said, I cried on the mountainside. I prayed to Jesus. And you can even see where my tears dropped on the... I thought, what a phony. Pastor Jess will be crying on pieces of paper tonight. It'll only be $1,000. How many would you like? It's a joke. I go to Mexico, and when they know we're coming to Guatemala or El Salvador, wherever we're going, they tell them, and they line up at the door. We're going to be there at 6 o'clock at night. At 1 o'clock in the afternoon, they're at the door. And by the time we get there, it looks like a 2 mile. I said, what are these people doing here? He said, well, you're the doctor today. I said, I'm the doctor today. I'm no doctor. I have a doctorate in theology. What do you want me to do? No, they come for prayer. I said, okay. They ever want to need healing, all these people? I said, yeah. I said, he said, there's no hospital here where we were. No hospital. One doctor for thousands of people. And they ain't got any money anyway. They come in and they just are beaming. They're so joyous and they're so happy, and you lay hands on them, not everybody, but almost. I prayed for him about an hour, and then my friend come up and prayed for him about an hour, and then another guy come, and many, many, many of them got healed. But we didn't do it. It was the name. Say the name of Jesus is full of power. Do you believe it? Has he ever done anything for you? What has he done for you, really? Somebody tell me what he did for you. So many times. I was in Guatemala, and I took a shower, and they said, don't take a shower in the water over where we were with those people, and I did. I started getting sick. I thought, what's in the water? I was washing my face, my eyes, my hands, everything, and get in the water, and they said, we told you not to drink it. I said, I didn't drink it. Yeah, but you can't put it in your eyes or nothing. I said, well, how do you take a bath? They said, well, you put a cloth over your eyes. Well, they didn't tell me that part. So this couple that I went with, you remember Carlos and Julie? Well, I was with them. They were translating for me there. Carlos said, come here, Pastor Dan, I'll pray for you. I said, okay. And he said, in the name of Jesus, I command for this all to leave him right now and he'll be healed. And he said, you want to go eat something? I said, yeah, let's go. When I got down there, it was all gone. Everything. Pain left. Eyes were red. Looked like I'd been drunk for a week. But when he got down there, it was gone. Did he do it? No, but the name that's above every name. He said, I'm going to give you power and authority. Through the name of Jesus. That's where the power source is. Not us. If we want to take credit for what God's done, that's a terrible thing. Don't do that. Don't ever do it, right? The secret of the power that you need in your life is the name of Jesus. A guy said to me, I prayed one time in the name of somebody that was an old saint years ago. He said, I prayed in his name, and we got a miracle. I said, what was it? He said he was totally healed. I said, what name did you use when you prayed for him? Are you ready? Name of Jesus. He goes to another church, believes something else, but when he went to pray for the guy, he prayed for him in the name of Jesus. He didn't even know what the Bible said, really. But you know what? He believed. I said, do you believe in Jesus? He said, of course. And I said, then I asked, well, what'd you pray? I prayed in the name of Jesus. And he got healed. I said, I believe it. Do you think a little kid, 6 years old, could lay hands on somebody and they get healed if they would pray in the name of Jesus? I seen it. This little girl was praying for her mama and they were in a line to be prayed for, and the little girl put her head on there, and she said, Mama, Jesus. I thought, see if that works. And she went, whoo, somebody hold this baby. She said, something just touched me. The power of God came on her. I asked her later, does your daughter know about Jesus? She said, she's saved. I said, how old is she? Looked like a baby. Said, well, she's about 3 years old. She is a baby. She said Jesus is all she said. Not a Zeus, but Jesus. Hey, Zeus? No, Jesus. Yeah, it means Jesus, but we're talking about the Jesus of the Bible. Did you understand that? Did I preach too long? Well, I need $1 million. Who's going to give me the first 500,000? Need anything? I don't need. Do you believe what I taught you? I read it from the Bible. If you'll trust in God's word and do what he says, God will use you. You know how Mary Lee can do all the stuff she does? Through the power of the Holy Spirit that's in her, and she knows what name to pray in. She's got gifts. told a guy, I said, talking about you, a pastor, I said, I got a friend in the church where I go a lot. You know, this is, hey, brother, this is my 11th year coming here. 11 years. I said, she's an older lady, but she hears from God, and when she gives you a word, it's real. And he said, I'd like to meet her. I said, come right up to the church, sit down. Probably catch you before you get out. And say something like, I don't really have the words, but I think I got something from God, and it's always from God. You see, she didn't say, I have everything. I got all the words and everything. Sometimes she said, you know, Pastor Dan, I'm not sure about the word I have. I want to ask you something, and then we're going to close. Truly. I already shut my Bible. Are you really saved? Are you in trouble right now? Somebody in here right now is in so much trouble, and you don't know how to get out, and you've been going to church, and that's good. You ought to go to church. Don't quit going to church. But you need to really believe in Jesus and His name more than anything else. And if you're not a Christian, you heard enough information today to get saved like that, and God's Spirit might come upon you, and it might not for the baptism of the Holy Spirit. But if you asked Him, He will give it to you. But if you're sick, we want to pray for you. Guess how we're going to do it? In the name of Jesus. But if you're not sure that you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, all you have to do, you don't even have to do it in front of pastors or anything. Just say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to forgive me of all my sins. And you said you would forgive me and cleanse me of all unrighteousness, Romans 10, 9 and 10. If you do that, He'll take away your sin. Will I feel it? No. But you'll notice that you're not like you were if you will yield. See, some people will come down and say, I confess Jesus Christ, Lord, I believe in my heart. And I'm there. They don't even know what they're talking about. And see, a lot of pastors say, now you're saved. I never tell them you're saved. Never. I ask them, are you saved? Do you feel different? Yeah, I feel different. Start coming to church. Do you really believe Jesus and His Word? Then build your life on it. I pray for myself in the name of Jesus, because when I go on these trips, nobody out there sometimes until the rest of the crew gets there, so just me. So I just pray for myself. You can do it too. I gave myself a word one time and didn't believe it. I got a word from the Lord, and I just wrote it down, and I thought, well, it just come out of my heart. No, that wasn't the end of it, but that thing that I read that day changed my life. Changed my life. God said, you're going to go around the world. I've sent you to cities and nations. It's in the Bible. And I said, cities and nations? How am I going to get there? I've done it. Almost, not completely, but almost around the world. We got some ladies in here that went over to China and smuggled Bibles in. Mary Lee was one of them. How old were you then, Mary Lee? Huh? Went over and smuggled Bibles over there. What are they trusting in? Jesus. So we got to get these Bibles over here. Help us, Jesus. They did it. Did Sister Pat go with you? Oh, she went one, you went a different one. So she's a missionary. And take words to the world and Bibles too. Everybody shut your eyes. Why? So you don't know other people's business. Most Christians shut one eye a little bit. If you got a real problem in your life, you don't have to tell me what it is. Just raise your hand. Okay, I see it. I see it. I see that one too. I see that one back there. Anybody else? Okay. It's amazing. There's not very many people here, but see, we all got needs. Let's stand up together, would you? If you've had a problem for a long, 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 long time, come down here. If you don't want to come down here, you don't have to. But if you want to, we'll lay hands on you. But if you don't come, we're just going to pray a prayer like that. And it works too. Anybody else, you got a real problem and you want to get rid of it, come on. The reason I preached this sermon this morning, and I didn't even really preach, just talk to you, is because God said there's people that are alive that have problems. Don't worry about the dead ones. Pray for those that are alive and have needs and problems in their life. Well, what can you do? What happens when you pray? God answers the prayer.
Praise the Lord. Let's give the Lord a clap offering this morning. Amen. You can be seated for just a moment. We're going to go ahead and receive a love offering for Pastor Dan. We're so thankful that you came today. Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. It's always good to be in the house of the Lord. I really do try to encourage people to come to church, even if they just sit in the pew and soak up the service. You'll be better for it if you'll come. God will bless you. Amen. Anything you can do this morning will be appreciated. I do want to remind everyone we still have a little over a week for our fast and praying. Many people have had a 21-day fast in the month of January, but we go all the way through the month, so it's 31 days. And Tuesday, next, a week from Tuesday, is going to be January 31st. And then February 1st will be our first Wednesday at 7 o'clock here. So we have just a little over a week yet to fast and pray. Let's continue to do that, that God's blessing may rest upon us. Amen. It's not by might or power, it's by the Spirit of God. And if you will pray and believe, it will happen. As long as you line it up with God's word, amen. Praise the wonderful name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you once again for this wonderful service. We thank you for letting us be here today. Lord, so many people, Lord, can't do what we did today in freedom to worship you, and we thank you for it. We ask you to bless this offering. Bless the gift and the giver, Lord, we pray, and we ask it in your name, the name of Jesus, and everyone said, amen. If you have an offering, please bring it to the storehouse of the Lord this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Would you stand with me, please? We're going to go ahead and dismiss in a word of prayer. We're going to ask our sister Mary Lee, would you dismiss us on today? Amen. God bless you this morning. Greet someone. And also we have the tithing for 2016. Please come up and see Linda, and she will give you the tither. Thank you.
Thank you for watching Rock of Faith. If you liked our service, please like and subscribe to our channel. If you really like our service, share it with a friend or family member. For the latest news and announcements, please go to our website, roffont.com. Our Google Calendar is on the front page. You can find the link in our video description.